Dear students, in lecture 5 we have discussed the various types of greenhouses. You know that in greenhouse the major important factor is how to get the desired environment. By getting desired environment we can grow the different type of crops around the year. The important environment parameters here is classified into air environment and soil environment. You know very well that in air environment, air temperature, light intensity, its quality, means quality means spectrum, day length, what is duration of light we are getting, relative humidity, carbon dioxide, and air velocity is very important. In soil environment, soil temperature and soil aeration and moisture is very important. We one by one will discuss the various environment factors. In temperature, I think in your plant physiology courses you have learned in detail. Here in this class we briefly will discuss the various environmental factors. You know very well that for each crop the desired environment temperature range is there. Each plant has certain environmental requirement, and for the crops certain range is there. Like suppose that depending upon the crops, 0 degree, at 0 degree it may be killed by the frost, and at a high temperature around 40 degrees C and above it will killed by the, it will not work, and it will, death of the plant can occur due to the desiccation. In temperature we will discuss about the air temperature, chilling, injury, heat stress, vernalization and soil temperature. You know very well that in air temperature, that as I told, for each crop the certain range is there. In that range the crops performs very well. And for each development stage, like for the you can say the vegetative growth, flowering, fruiting, color development, each stage the day night temperature is different. For the, you can normally the, for the crop 12 to 24 degrees is the best range. And most crops can be classified according to the optimum air temperature range. Normally the crops are classified based on the, suppose that those crop grow and develop below 18 degrees C are cool season crops, and those grow above the 18 degrees C are warm season crop. Chili injury, as we discussed, that the at most crop are injured at temperature at or slightly below freezing temperature, right? And as you know that the chilling injury depending upon your types of crops, its variety, and at which stage your crop is there. In heat stress, already initially we discussed that the, when temperature rises too high, heat destruction of the protoplast results in a cell death. This occurs in the range of 45 to 55 degrees. This is the general range here it is given. Especially if the heat stress is very high, means the high temperature and solar radiation is also high, the fruit temperature increases, and due to that the sunburn of tomato, already we discussed in the seed net structure, temporary seed net structure. And apart from what is the vernalization, it is the exposure of plant to low temperature for extended period of time which then induces or accelerates flowering and the or bolting is a unwanted flowering. So depending upon the your crops, the this process occurs. Here we discuss about the what is the air temperature required for tomato, specific for tomato. Depending upon each crop has the different requirement. For tomato grows well in warm weather, air temperature of 10 degrees C or below will delay the seed germination, inhibit vegetative development, reduce fruit set and impair fruit ripening. And certainly as we discussed that the required temperature range for the tomato is between 18.5 to 26.5 degree. That is the best range. And certainly the air temperature at the night and day will be different. And there is a minimum temperature below that, there is no growth. That is the, you used to say the base temperature for tomato, it is a 10.5 degree C air temperature. If the temperature is below 10.5 degree C, the growth will be very negligible. And normally you used to talk about the air temperature, but the canopy temperature is more important appropriate measure of the your growing temperature measurement. So we can measure the canopy temperature, and that, because that gives the more appropriate picture of the temperature. Apart from the air temperature, soil temperature also plays a very important role. and it depends upon the its soil temperature depends upon the which type of soil is there and what is the moisture status and what is the status of crop above this soil and moisture status also and what is the season, because during round the year the based on the air temperature your soil temperature also changes, and depending on the type of soil, if it is a clay soil or sandy soil or black soil, so depending upon the soil, because the light absorption will be different. And you should know very well that the soil temperature plays a very important role in seed germination, because it affects the root development and water and nutrient absorption by the root, because all the metabolic activity, if your soil temperature is low, your water and nutrient absorption by root will be disturbed, microbial growth and development, organic matter decay. So what I want to say that apart from the your air temperature, soil temperature plays a very important role. Here you can see the normally for tomato 20 to 30 degrees C is the optimum range for the soil temperature, and if it drops below the root, as we discussed that it affects the, because soil temperature affects your, already we discussed that the nutrient absorption or your water uptake, and that will affect the your metabolic activity. Here in picture figure 1 you can see that the influence of root zone temperature on the major nutrient. Major nutrient means the nitrate, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, magnesium. You can see from the picture that the soil temperature affects majorly. You can see that it affects the potassium more, and you can also see the ammonium nitrate and also the calcium. Same way you can see that the what is the effect of soil temperature on the absorption of micronutrient by the tomato. Here you can also see that the it affects the your you can see the iron majorly affects the iron, or you can see that the zinc and then magnesium, and it affects the other parameter in different way. So as we discussed that the apart from the your air temperature, soil temperature also plays the very important role. Here this is the general table. You can see here the data for the vegetables and flowers is given, like what is minimum lethal temperature, what is minimum biological temperature, night optimum temperature, daily optimum temperature, maximum biological temperature, minimum germination. So it is very interesting table, what is the CO2 requirement, and for selected vegetables and selected flowers the data has been given. You know very well that what is growing degree day, because growing degree day means the suppose that it is a weather based indicator for assessing crop development. We can for any crop you can calculate growing degree day for soil also, soil temperature and for air temperature both. And what is you can calculate growing degree days by T max, means the for last 24 hour what was your maximum temperature and what was your minimum temperature divided by 2, and T base, already I told that for tomato the T base is 10.5 degree C for air temperature, right? For soil temperature also the T base will be different. So what I am saying that if you have the for last 24 hour what is the your maximum temperature, minimum temperature, and for each crop the T base the temperature is different, means that the temperature below which the your biological activity almost stops. Okay, so for growing the crops, for each crop, for each stage you will able to calculate the what is the growing degree day, and based on that we have it is very important to know that the which is more important in growing the crop, means the your soil temperature is playing major role in biology, in your plant growth, or air temperature, or vice, or both. So it is very important, means the suppose that only by mulching, if it is possible, then we can go for only mulching. There is no need, if you suppose that in winter air temperature is low, and if you are using the black mulch, then that will increase the soil temperature. So you have to calculate that the if there is need to increase this air temperature or not. So based on the growing degree day, we can calculate the your what is growing degree day for crop, and it helps in predicting maturity, cutting dates of forage crop, predict best timing of fertilizer or pesticide application. So it is very important parameter for any crop. And for controlling the air and soil temperature, separately we will discuss later on that how to control the air temperature. Means the in poly house, if the air, suppose that in open field air temperature is low, so how to control the in greenhouse, suppose that your air temperature is low, okay, so how to there is different way. In a separate class we will discuss about the cooling and heating of greenhouse. Apart from the air temperature, in soil temperature also, as I told you, that the depending upon your air temperature, indirectly it affects your soil temperature. Apart from that, by heating the soil, the different mechanism is there. By that, we can heat the soil also in greenhouse. Apart from that, plastic mulching, already we have discussed that. By plastic mulching, we can increase or decrease the your soil temperature. Apart from temperature, the next important parameter is light. Light plays a very important role. Okay, because it affects your photosynthesis and all the biological activity. In light, as I told you, the three parameters is important. What is light intensity, what is light quality, and day length. Day length means what is duration of light the plant is receiving, because it changes around the year and depending upon your location also, and which location you are growing the crop. And in season also around the year, as I told you, light quality means the what part of a spectrum the solar light we are getting, which part you are getting plant is receiving. Apart from the light intensity, it is degree of brightness, means the what is the, means the what, how much intense the light is the plant is getting, because it also varies around the year. In winter, the light intensity is low, in summer, the light intensity is very high. So for characterization of light, in the three parameters very important. What is intensity, its quality, means the wavelength or color of the light the plant is receiving, and day length. You know that the light is the form of electromagnetic that is visible to human eye. The light you are seeing, that is the visible light that normally you used to see, but the visible light is the very small part of your electromagnetic spectrum that includes gamma ray, x-ray, UV, infrared, microwave, radio wave. Okay, and normally to measure the light, we can measure in the watt per meter square, means the how much energy you are getting on the per meter square area. Apart from that, we can also measure in number of photons, means the what is the micromole per square meter per second, means the there you are getting the joule per meter square per second. Here in terms of number of photons the plant or any particular 1 meter square area in 1 second is getting, that is the we can measure the in measure the energy or number of photons. You know very well in 10th standard also you have read about these things. The radiation from the sun can be described by its wavelength and its frequency. You know that we can calculate the energy by sc by lambda h nu, and nu is equal to, you know that the nu is equal to is c by lambda. C is the velocity of light, and no, it from equation it is very clear that if your wavelength is low, means if it is UV light, the energy is, it carries more energy, and if you move farther in the this spectrum, if it is radio wave, if your wavelength is high, so it contains less energy. And there are very important terms. Here you can see, already we have discussed about the transmittance, absorbs. Suppose that at any place if light is coming, suppose that you are in poly house structure, you have a cladding material, so cladding material is there, so some light it will transmit, some it will absorb, your cladding material will absorb, and some it will reflect. Depending on, in mulch also you have discussed that depending upon the color, thickness, other parameter, it affects your transmittance, absorptance and reflectance. Apart from that, in poly house also you are getting direct light and diffuse light. Diffuse light radiation has been reflected by the atmosphere or glazing material. So total radiation the plant that is getting in the greenhouse is here, direct and diffuse light. So what is the photoactive radiation? You know very well that the wave band of the electromagnetic spectrum used by for photosynthesis, you are more concerned about the 400 to 700 nanometer, used to say in short PAR, means the photosynthetically active radiation. What is PPF, photosynthetic photon flux density? Here you measure number of photons in that PAR wave band. Apart from that, the photosynthetic irradiance is there, means the radiated energy stream in the PAR wave band. What is the energy the your plant is getting or that is coming on the your cladding material greenhouse surface? Then a spectral irradiance is there, energy value or distribution of, means the here the, you get the number of wavelength per unit wavelength. Here you can see the spectrum various wave band that the of the total solar radiation reaching the earth, 97% of the that spectrum is a spectral distribution. The light, the solar radiation that is reaching at the earth surface is between between 280 to 2800 nanometer, 97% is there, and remaining is, and of this means the from 280 to 2800, 44% is between PAR or visible, roughly. PAR means photoactive radiation, that is we are more concerned, and 4% is UV, ultraviolet ray, and the remainder is between 52%. So from the picture it is clear that you can see that from this is the radiation spectrum with the various wave band. You can see that you can also calculate the your energy, wavelength, and wavelength is also given, frequency is also given. So from here you will able to calculate the, if you know the wavelength of the any wavelength, then if you are able to calculate the its energy. Apart from that, as I told you that UV is there, in UV also UVA, UVB, UVC is there, and you know that the UVC is the between 100 to 200, 280 nanometer, so it has more energy, and UVA between 320 to 400, it carries less energy in comparison to your UVC. As I told you that visible light is a 380 to 770 nanometer band, that is that you usually used to see by human eye. Here you can see that it is the spectrum 400 to 700, how the your different color of the your photoactive radiation PAR is given. You can see that the color of the radiation visible to human can be divided into flowing wave band, that the violet, blue, green, yellow, orange, and each has its own activity, means how it helps in the functions of plant. You can see in blue, a minimal quantity is necessary to prevent. So each color has its own role in the your in its biological activity. Infrared, you know very well that the infrared is the greater than 770 nanometer, and up to 1 lakh nanometer includes the near infrared and the short wave infrared. And if the ratio of red and far red plays very important role in photo morphogenic, we'll discuss later on. From this picture 6, it is clear that as we increase your light radiation, so as you increase the radiation the plant is receiving, so it increases the growth of plant, but after some time it becomes plateau. So because apart from your solar light the plant energy the plant is receiving, other factor, your moisture, CO2, other factor also plays a very important role. Apart from that, here you can see that in figure 7, it is comparison between your visible range that the human used to see and the far range. So one is the normally human you can say the visible range between visible range, and two is the plant that is giving photoactive radiation. You can see that the human eye cannot even begin to respond to many of the wavelength before 500 nanometer. From picture it is clear, you can see the one is the before before 500, it is very, for human being it is very difficult to respond, and after 600 nanometer also. But for PAR you can see the plant response, however, extends beyond PAR wave band also. Photomorphogenesis, as I told you, it is ability of light to regulate the plant growth and development independent of photosynthesis. It is different than photosynthesis. Plant process that appear to for photomorphogenic include internodal elongation, means the in your plant growth, the internodal elongation, chlorophyll development, flowering, lateral bud growth, root and shoot growth is affected by photomorphogenesis. And here only the red or far red portion of a wavelength plays a very important role. Here the phytochrome, the plant pigment responsible for light, because the light regulated growth, the phytochrome plays an important role. Phytochrome is the colorless pigment that is in plants in very small amounts. As I told you, depending upon the orientation of, because in your greenhouse structure you have a cladding material, different gadget you have put, so depending on type of structure, already we have discussed what is the shape, pitch of the roof, how much light you are getting inside the greenhouse, and plant is getting that much light, that is affected by the various parameters. Depending on the types of cladding material, it will also affect your how much light the plant is getting, and location of the equipment within the greenhouse, types of cladding material, as I told, orientation of sun, these are the important factors that affect the the your plant is getting the light inside the greenhouse structure. There are various type of sensors are there that normally used in the greenhouse structure to measure the important parameters. The pyranometer, you know very well, that as I told you, that the 97% of the solar solar radiation that is between 280 to 2800, 90, so normally it measure in the watt per meter square. And you are more concerned about the quantum. So what is quantum sensor? It's the far wavelength, means the 400 to 700. You can measure the number of photons also, means the micromole per meter square per second, or in terms of energy, means the watt per meter square. Then apart from that, a spectroradiometer is there. It splits the incoming radiation into the individual wavelength and its unit, as you know, that here the you are talking about the particle wavelength, so unit will certainly change, means the watt per meter square per nanometer or micromole per meter square per second per nanometer. You can measure the light in different way, means the which part of a spectrum you are measuring, means the as I told you that in pyranometer it measure between 280 to 2800, but PAR measures, quantum sensor measure between your 400 to 700. So here how can convert the one reading measurement in other parameter, means the if you measure the how to convert the irradiance or and luminosity to PAR or vice versa, means the if you have irradiance data or luminosity, means the light you are seeing, then how you will able to convert into photoactive radiation. Quantum PAR sensor measure light only in the photo PAR range, already we discussed, but the while the irradiance or luminosity sensor measure light over a broader range, so conversion is very difficult among the units because the different light source has the different conversion factor. As you know that the depending upon your location and season, the natural light is not sufficient to grow the crop. Sometime if you want to grow the fasten the or the biological photosynthetic activity and the overall growth of the plant, normally people used to give the artificial light. In artificial light, there are different types of lighting is there. First is replacement lighting. Replacement lighting means the we are removing the all, means the here we are giving the complete replacement of solar radiation using the artificial lighting. In supplement, apart from the solar light, we are using supplement lighting to increase your you are providing supplement light apart from the your depending upon your location. As I told you that the depending upon your light intensity the plant is getting, what is the duration, what is the spectrum. So if you use the artificial light, it certainly will depending upon the light source, you will able to increase the duration, intensity, depending upon the which type of light source you are using, and a spectrum also, depending upon the light source, you can choose the different type of light source that will provide the desired light spectrum, means light color. And there are various factors that affect the your artificial lighting, depending upon the which type of crop you are going, what is the natural day length. So depending upon the location, requirement, how much economics you are getting. Suppose that you are providing artificial lighting, certainly it will add the cost of your artificial lighting system, energy and so on. So depending upon the our requirement and cost economics, normally people used to add artificial lighting. There are different for artificial lighting, different types of lamps is there, incandescent lamp, fluorescent lamp and discharge lamps is there. And the in lamps normally apart from the lighting the source, there are different types of light fixture is there, means the whole system is there, like the lamp, reflector, blast and housing, that in to provide the plant properly the light, so that the plant can get the light properly. And in whenever you are going for artificial lighting, there are various factors are there that is very important. Light, what is light efficiency, means the how much the suppose that we have fixed the light, how much the plant is, suppose that any crop is there, so how much light it is getting in the PAR range. So what is light means the per watt, how much light you are getting for photosynthetic activity. What is life span, means what is life span of your artificial light, then intensity, what is intensity of the that light, then spectral quality, means the color of the light the plant is receiving, then cost, what is cost of your artificial light, and apart from that, what is electrical requirement. Because if you add the artificial light, certainly it will add the cost. in incandescent